Imagine a restaurant where the menu offers full life, more life, better life, eternal life. Who wouldn't want a taste of that? In this special conference, Kathy Tricoli and Ellie LaFaro share an inspirational message of abundant faith, hope, and love. With solid biblical teaching, relevant stories, an uplifting concert, and a healthy dose of humor, Spaghetti for the Soul is sure to strengthen your faith. Kathy and Ellie remind us that there is a spiritual feast laid out for us that is sure to nourish our souls. Woven throughout this series, Kathy and Ellie celebrate their friendship through their New York roots and Italian heritage. Come to the table.
How's your fruit basket? Are you bearing fruit? Is it sweet? Is it multiplying? Is it juicy? Do people choose to reach in and have some? I find some days that I am that crabapple tree on The Wizard of Oz. What do you want? Get away from me! That's me just before dinner. But I want to be that sweet fruit. I want to be the one. I want to be that tree. I want to be that tree in Psalms where I can be at the riverside and I can have deep roots and whatever I grow and touch will prosper. And I want to give shades to my friends. And I want to be the cool lady on the block where the teenagers can come and feel safe with their problems. And I want to be the friend that when you tell me your secret, I'm not going to repeat it. I want to be that tree, that oak tree that really took a long time to grow. Not that little whippersnapper tree that's going to bend and be lost in the storm.
He sees what we can't. We live behind veiled faces right now. I often say I think heaven's going to be like the great aha moment. You know, like I should have had a V8? That's going to be heaven, you know, like, oh, you mean, oh, I get it. That's why, I didn't understand that at the time, Lord. God is big enough to do things that we have labeled impossible.
We know what God did in the Red Sea. We've seen what God has done. We know what God is doing. We believe what God will do. That's what faith. I know God did this for my friend. I know now that he might not do the same thing for me, but I trust that he can, and I'll wait for his miracle. I've seen God heal marriages. I've seen God deliver people from horrendous addictions. I've seen God bring people out of terrible, terrible things. I've seen God help people to make up, and I've seen God do physical miracles. I believe that God can do it again. I believe that God is still in the miracle business.
Hope has a plan. Hope has a plan. He has designs for your life. He sees long term, and we see short term. That's just how it works. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. I know the plans." That's the part we miss when we hear this verse. I know. Hello, I'm God. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to give you a hope and a future.
This was up on the bulletin board, and all of the thin blonde women were all looking at the bulletin board, and they were laughing at mine, and I couldn't understand. I was pouring the bug juice for the holiday party, and it said missionary plane. And how sweet. Frank was roaming around the country and traveling all over the world for prison fellowship and helping micro-enterprise startups, and he saw his dad as a missionary. His sister Paris as a roving lioness, mighty and just out there and being strong. He saw himself as possibly a fire-breathing creature, something mighty. And then in the fourth quadrant, there was a fat bear sleeping.
Maybe someday, after a few million years, we'll have some moments alone. We can sit for a while and you can make clear all the things I've never known. There are so many questions but so little time, but one thing I can't seem to get off my mind. For the life of me, I don't understand why you love me like you do.
Come to the table.